This is Decker Island. This is part of the Fish Restoration Program, where we're restoring 8,000 acres of tidal wetland habitat in the Delta and Sassoon Marsh. This is a very opportune location in the Delta for Delta smelt in that it's down near the interface between freshwater and saltwater, and that's where Delta smelt like to be. This is one of 13 projects that we have under the Fish Restoration Program, together with the California Department of Fish and Wildlife. And right now, as you can see, it's in construction. We are breaching the levees and allowing the tides back in.
With this Decker Island project, DWR is going to restore approximately 140 acres of tidal habitat. We have four design features. We have a breach that will be open to the tides all the time. The water is just constantly moving on and off passively with the tides. The second feature is a levee degrade. When the tide comes up, water is going to overtop that levee and it's going to flood the site. The last two features are notches in two of the three berms that are on site. And by doing that, we're allowing water to hit, we hope, the entire site. And all of that is to let water onto the site, produce food that Delta smelt need, and then move it off site with the tides going out.
We're trying to make what is already a wetland into a tidal wetland. Right now it's ringed by levees, so it's not open to the tides. What we're doing is we're punching holes in the levees, we're allowing the tide to come in on a daily basis and flow in and out of the site. What that does is it takes the productivity, the small creatures that are growing and proliferating and reproducing in this site, and exports them out into the Delta where they can be eaten by other fishes. So really, these tidal wetlands are the breadbaskets of the Delta. This is where the basis of the food web is created that gets exported out into the rest of the sloughs and the other waterways where fish can eat it. This is a really important ecological function in the Delta, and it's something that has been greatly diminished. It's estimated that 150 years ago, there were 350,000 acres of tidal wetland habitat in the Delta. Today, there's about 10,000 acres. So that's a loss of 97%. When you take that into account and you look at all these fish that are declining, not just Delta smelt, there's a whole host of fish that are declining in the Delta. That's one of the reasons, is they don't have the food anymore because these areas that they're being produced have been greatly diminished. So that's why we're focusing on tidal wetland habitat. That's what we're trying to put back. And when the Fish Restoration Program is finished, we will about double the amount of existing tidal wetland habitat in the Delta today.